as usual, planting the cauliflower. I got them from doing side quests, the 300 gems. I did a lot of side quests, and that is why I have all those gems. Okay, come on. Yep. Here we go. So we need to plant more sticky bomb rice. We are leading right now, but things can change quickly in arena mode. Again, so it's a points contest literally now. We are leading by around 100 and now he's gaining on us again. All about getting enough points by the time the game ends. So who finishes with most points at the end, that matters. Victory. So let's see what plants he had. He took the regular sunflower. Okay, he took the primal potato mine though. I thought the bomb type plants were not powerful in this. It was a bruise rather than a buff. Don't think he had anything to hit the jester with. Yes. Got 50 hocus crocus. Very near our goal. Let's see if we can upgrade anything right now. Okay, so we have a lot of plants in the Zen garden which we can use in adventure mode, but right now I'm curious to play the side quest for the arena practice room. It will show us how our next tournament will look like. Okay, so Torchwood is ready to upgrade. Let's get it then. The sun cost is reduced, toughness, damage all increase. Let's play the arena practice room. Okay, we get this Zoibean pod. But the enemies certainly look tougher in this level. There are squid and this bull rider imps. Oof. Enchanted plants are more powerful. Take them. There are chicken zombies as well. This is going to be extremely tough. We'll try some stuff. We have 3 rounds to go, so we can experiment a bit. Okay, we have some soybean pods already in place. Okay, Brick League, that's cool. There it goes. Okay, so let's plant some of more of the joy beans. Need more those pods. More soybean pods are always welcome. Okay, so you saw some plant which get lot of points. So which plant Do you mean the soybean pod or the sticky bomb rice? The soybean. Even I have not unlocked it. I think it's available only in the arena mode right now. I still need to unlock it. And we'll try something else. We'll take regular ones. Maybe we'll try the repeater and the torchwood. Yeah, I think the power of the soybean pod sends out a Gargantor, from what I've seen. Here we need the soybean zombies are a bit weaker though. I think if we give them enough plant food, they'll grow stronger. But the soybean does send out a lot of them in massive waves. Whole lot of soybean. Now we have two rows of them. So, using the enchantment brought out soybeans with watermelon helmets. That's cool. Now, this time, let's try something different. We'll try mainly enchanted plants this time, since we have them anyways. Do we have any other enchantment family plants? I don't think so. Okay, then we'll go with the sticky bomb. Let's just stick with the iceberg lettuce. Sending out hypno shrooms now. Saving up now we have watermelon head soybean zombies on our side. I think they are equivalent to the bucket head zombies. Definitely looks like it. Soybean planted. Here they come. So the soybeans look like they are upgraded now. So we finished the epic quest for arena practice room. So let's go into adventure mode. Frostbite Caves. We're on to level 7 now. We unlocked the pepper pulp last time. Okay, global cooling is the pitch. What we need is a heat wave. Please note I have now replaced the snowballs with fireballs. Okay. Flamethrower power up melts frost and damages zombies too. Revenge is a dish best served cold. It's best served hot, fiery hot with extra hot sauce. Okay. So Crazy Dave is all about tacos. Let's get something to get this level done. Let's just use the kernel pult. We'll take the fire pea shooter just to keep it company, and it's ready to be upgraded. Let's upgrade it. The recharge time decreased, damage and toughness both increased. Okay. Hot potato is of course important here. Take the jalapeno, cherry bomb. Now let's not take the jalapeno, we'll take the iceberg lettuce instead. Hot potato definitely is important here. We need to get all the 5 out, and now we can start putting the heat on them. Oops. Hola, my friend. Sorry mate, I don't speak Spanish. So the final wave is coming in. And I think an easy victory awaits us. Kaboom! So the bee did its job. Now it's time for us as well to get to the next level. So we are on to level 8. So this looks like a mini game type of level. Play. So this is mainly conveyor belt level. Good enough. I think we need to plan these a bit better. Here we go. So I cannot really nothing is visible at the moment. We are just firing in the blind. There's way too much fog this level. Okay, I think now I can allow them. to explore. Come to potato. Got a pinata. What the pinata holds. Coins, pepper pulp, which is ready to be upgraded. Stunions, okay.
June 2013. An incredible wave might be 100.
Let's upgrade some things. Now that upgrades are available, it's best to do it when it's there, so pepper pulled can be upgraded again. Recharge time decreases, toughness and damage both increase. And I think we can go into the Zen Garden and get something as well. This level. Nope. Zen Garden. Where we want to go right now. Yeah, let's take the homing thistle, let's try it off in this level. Of course, we need to support it with some plant which can heat it up. Or even a lava guava will work. Yeah, let's use the lava guava. It's cheaper. And anyway, we have the homing thistle for ranged attack. This will be like the last line of defense. Let's get along. So there's some really weird kind of sounds from the frostbite caves. Coming in, so we'll send them back on their way. Oh. So the homing thistle needed, so that did its work. Now we need to plant some lava guavas. To keep them heated. That was neat. So the iceberg lettuce obviously does not work. On the dodo rider. So we send them back. But we can make it disappear. So, insert taken out. Yep, victory. Kaboom, I did not even need to use it. Coins, coins, coins. Lot of coins. Okay, one more spring bean, which is not helpful in Frostbite Caves. Its usefulness starts and ends in Pirate Seas, but in Pirate Seas it is definitely the most useful plant. There's nothing really that compares to the spring bean in Pirate Seas, especially when boosted with a power up. It can beat the Gargantor in one shot if the Gargantor is at the edge of the plank. So one hit knockout plant if used correctly, but only in Pirate Seas. One more minigame type level. Cave zombies are hard-headed, take no brains for an answer. So they are Neanderthal zombies, okay. 33. Okay, we can use the charred guard now. Get charred guards now. Oh, so the charred guard, the tiles, arrow tiles will not stop the dodo zombie. So we need to beat them the old school way. Getting some hot potato. This is a sign of things to come. Actually, the sign of things which are already here. Oh. This is the final wave. Yep. Then it's time to use power ups. Flag zombie can go down right now. Let's go to the next level. Level 11, and after one more, we can get the charred guard. Okay, so we have most of the plants picked up for us. Okay, we get sunstorm, three peter, chili bean, potato, and a chart card. So we need to take the torch food. And the appeasement. So temporarily push them, slow them down using the combination of the charred guard and the chili bean, and build up on the three peters. And that's how we do it. Can chili beans warm plants? I'm not entirely sure. Uh-oh.